Hello dear viewers, welcome to iTesla Solutions in partnership with CyberDoc LLC. In the today video I am going to show you a method which I used for desoldering the SIM slot from the iPhone X and up. This method works most of the time without any special preheater or other such tools. This is iPhone 11 Pro Max SIM slot, and I have looked at which parts hold it in place, and I think that this method will work even here. And I will prove you from the previous videos, which I know that you think that I show you only how I weld it back, but I don't show you how I desolder it, because I forgot to record those memos. But now I will show you and you will believe me. So let's begin. I'm turning on my soldering iron with 350 of temp, with a special brass tip from CyberDoc LLC. Hope you see it. It's exactly the same size as the pads on the SIM slot, which are welded to the bottom of the logic board. And I see that Apple have soldered it in such a way so that it will be easy to desolder and replace. In my opinion, Apple did a good job. And in today's video we will be doing the desoldering. So first step, after the soldering iron have heated, what we must do first is add QuickAlloy from same website of CyberDoc LLC, the best website for soldering supplies. So I take a piece of low melt alloy, QuickAlloy, and I will solder. Of course my solder is old, that's why I will have to clean a little bit with flux on the side of jeans. So most important are these ground pads. So we add solder to this, to every pad of the SIM slot. You can hold soldering iron for more longer, so the solder will penetrate and mix well. And do this with all the pads. First, I think I will clean the solder on each pad after I weld, and add again QuickAlloy. And this will make the solder to penetrate the pads, through the holes, because there is ordinary solder from Apple factory. So I will add more of this. Fuck, it has melted. This drop of solder is QuickAlloy. I think that on the positive pads, which are not ground, you can do this once. Only one time, I think. But if you want, you can do twice. For ground parts, I think 1-2 times will be enough. Because this is a dual SIM slot, there are more parts to weld than the previous modules. Okay, let me add this big solder. So for ground parts you can hold the soldering iron for more time. I did a video recent, let me remember. The iPhone 11 logic board separation. Unfortunately, I realized that I was using the wrong copper wick, which is for cleaning the solder. It was thicker and bigger. Cut a piece of copper braided wick, which is already full of solder, and add flux to the copper wick to make it work better. So I am recording with two cameras. I hope there is enough charge on my DSLR camera. Okay, so I have cleaned it a little bit. And this is it now, in my opinion. Okay, let me take solder. Let me show how it was sent. This is the solder from CyberDoc LLC in a plastic tube. So I have some left here, which is also for a lot of time, because I don't do many jobs. Okay, it has broke a piece. So I recommend you to buy such solder, because it will help you a lot. So let me add again to the ground part. In my opinion, this is enough. So now I will clean, because I don't like when the from jeans hairs are stick to the bottom of this flux at all. Because I like everything when it's clean. Okay, we have prepared the parts from this side. Now we will weld the remaining parts, which keep the seam slot welded with the same QuickAlloy. And there are parts which are not accessible. So I will show you what I do if they are not accessible. This part is not really accessible, but I will leave it, because it will remove. And this part on the bottom of, on the back of the seam slot are not accessible, but these ones are accessible. So what we need to do here is add flux and weld with QuickAlloy. I see that the solder did not penetrate well, but that is not really important, because when I will hit this location, they will unweld easy. Because I already did this and I know how it works. The next step, which I will not do in this video because I need to separate the logic boards after this video. So in your case, I recommend you to cover these areas of the application logic board in such a way so that it will not be heated, because 220 temp is enough to melt those interposer pads, but I will not cover them. So I will just turn my heat gun with 220 of heat and will heat the seam slot area. Full airflow. And I will begin to desolder the seam slot. Have a better idea because this plastic is not so important. Okay, I will add more QuickAlloy because I see it did not penetrate the parts which are ground. Okay, I feel it. Very sorry, dear viewers. It seems that my camera stopped recording and turned it off, fucking shit of camera. And I'm not sure what you have seen. I have desoldered the seam slot. And a little bit this pin got out, but I don't think it's damaged. It will be possible to build it back. So the seam slot is held on the back of seam with this welded parts to the logic board. But they are not really important. What holds in place the seam slot are all these crouch hole parts. And those are not really needed, so you can break them if you are just... No, I think you will replace the seam slot and don't care about how you remove it. But this seam slot, believe me, is still good. So let's clean the logic board. And I'm not sure to show you how I put it back or not. And prepare for the welding back. Now I understand why the C seems a lot was harder to desolder. On the previous models, the pads were not so big because they were attached via small on the thin side of the seam slot, but on this model the pads, ground pads which keep it, hold it, are bigger inside. That's why it was harder to desolder the seam slot. But my method worked, I'm sure. If I look at the pads, let me check. I don't see the logic guards didn't desolder it with that temp. But as I told you, cannot Kapton type for protection. Make sure to make all the pads flat, like the surface of the earth. The designers know very good which how must be the base of any creation. It must be flat, else your project is a crap. When you build a house, you must have a flat surface and level it. If it's not, then it's junk of project. Any designer knows this. You will not need to solder these back pads, which are not accessible. So I think better to clean this 3 times. You can lift the soldering iron temperature to 375, because I feel there is not enough temperature for the ground pads. So to solder back this connector, I think you don't have to see how I solder it back. You just put the new connector and solder all the accessible parts. That's all you have to do. The most challenging is the soldering. Dental tool I have for extracting nerves, see, it's going through, and this is enough for the seam pins to penetrate. Not sure, but I feel Apple added some hard solder to the seam pads. I feel that. Because it's a little bit weird that I had such temp on soldering iron. and they just did not melt when I was soldering. It's not excluded for Apple to change solder, because they know that the SIM slot is a psychical slot and it has moving parts. And if humans replace SIM many times, this is like bending a wire. And they called half added harder solder. But no, the purpose of, you will see the SIM slot welded in order when I will separate the logic board. So I will just show you at the end that I clean this SIM slot. This is that pin which have the most hard have melted. And you have seen that it was hard to clean on the logic board. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, share, subscribe. Spread the word. And don't forget to come to our websites. I test as solutions for solutions, schematics, videos, ideas, and to CyberDoc LLC for soldering consumables, for soldering supply. We will make more videos, one of new models possible. So, guys, let me zoom out. Have a good day. Bye.